This is Transformers Prime Beast Hunters Deluxe Class Bumblebee. The figure is part of the first wave of the Beast Hunters Deluxe Class series of figures. Let's have a quick look at the packaging. It's a smaller card. Hasbro's really cost-cutting on these figures. As you can see, there is no artwork on the box for Bumblebee. It's just photoshopped images of the toys. It's a shame. Wanted to see how Bumblebee actually looks like on the show. Interesting also to note is that on the instruction manual, there is a part that says Tales of the Beast Hunters Chapter 1. Has a little bit of a storyline here. If you want to be spoiled and get a little bit of spoilers for the show, you just want to pause the video and read through it. It says Chapter 2 continued in the Deluxe Soundwave. So I guess there's a order in which you should buy and open the toys. So you need to find out the story about how Bumblebee finds the weapons, how they try and stop the Predacon, and whatever. So, interestingly enough, I actually like this figure. Never been a big fan of the mold. The mold was okay. This RID Bumblebee, Deluxe Class Bumblebee, was okay. But I wasn't going gaga over the mold. But it is interesting what a slight modification, slight retooling of a particular mold can do, how it can do wonders for the mold. Especially in this case, the figure looks awesome. I mean, it is phenomenal. I mean, a lot of people are saying, ah, crap, it's another Bumblebee figure. Who needs another Bumblebee figure, right? But I wish I could show you the RID version, but I had given it to Alex, and Alex has somehow misplaced that figure. Anyway, let's try and get rid of his weapons. Let's look at the bear figure. As you can see, the head has been retooled to a slightly Trojan-looking, more warrior-looking Bumblebee. They've retooled the shoulders to have the spikes. They've retooled the feet to have more spikes. And they've retooled the doors to have these rotating missile missile racks. But everything else is the same about the figure. It is the RID mold that has just been retooled or redecoed. Now, a lot of these new Beast Hunters figures have these smudges in the plastic. Like, for instance, this one has a lot of the red, orangey type of swirls in the plastic. Wheeljack has grays. Ripclaw and Laserback, they have all these paint smudges about them. I don't know if it's like Hasbro was trying to do a weathered look for these bots, or they're just careless errors in production. But anyway, they look intentional, for at least. But yeah, I mean, just the slight modification really gives new meaning to this figure, and I actually like it. The alt mode is just great. I thought I would hate it. I really, really thought I would hate this figure, but as it turns out, I'm a big fan. Now, the figure comes packaged in a slightly squat position because of the bubble. He comes packed this way. So you think he's squat. He comes packed this way. But he's really not. I mean, the proportions are okay. And the Hasbro figure, it's just kids who are going to buy this, and there's really no need to market it that much to the adult collector. It has the same type of articulation as the RID, so there's really no need to discuss too much about it. He still comes with his blasters, which you can mount, as you've seen earlier, on the forearms. You can keep it. Now you can have him hold it two hands. You can have it mounted this way and store it at the back. He comes with his Eagle Shot crossbow, what did I call it? The Eagle Shot bow, which, according to the manual, instantly locks on targets up to 3 miles away, fires charged plasma bolts that melt through hot metal, to most metal. Smart bolts track targets even around corners. So they're homing targets, these smart bolts. This is the weapon that Bumblebee took on. He's the guy who found all the weapons that they will use to fight the Predacons. It's a hair trigger. Pretty cool. You can store the weapons here. There's a groove for the missiles, like that. You have one in, and then you can fold it up this way. He can hold it like a crossbow, or have it on his forearm, or just store it at the back. The weapons in robot mode can sit on the missile rack like that, but I want to show you the alt mode without the missiles. So anyway, let's get right to it. It's a very easy transformation, just like the RID version. There's really not much to it. Just fold the these shoulder pads, just fold them forward, collapse it, and the head goes down. Go ahead and rotate these and fold that up. Now we'll do the arms later. Go ahead and fold the feet up, join the feet together, snap them in like that. Make sure you snap these in. Same here, snap it in and go like that. And there is Bumblebee in his Camaro-ish spiky beast hunting sports muscle car alt mode. It rolled very well despite the very, very low clearance underneath all the kibble. It still rolls very well. And I mean, just these modifications of spikes, I thought it was ridiculous to have cars with spikes, but I actually like it. There's different types of colors here and there. This one is light yellow. These are darker yellow. Lemon and canary yellows, all about, but you know, it's fine. Again, Hasbro probably figured its kids are going to buy this. Collectors are not going to want it. Anyway, very, very nice. Again, I'm very impressed with this mold for some reason. I mean, it's just a small retooling of the mold, and again, it just becomes this really brilliant mold. So again, mount all of the weapons in to just make him a sort of Mad Max Predacon killing machine. And yeah, you can fold the crossbow like that. It looks much sleeker this way. You can keep the crossbow open if you want, give it more spikes, as it were. Yeah, so pretty cool. All in all, I like this figure. If you've never considered buying it, I suggest you do a double take on it. If you know, as of this posting, as of this filming of this particular review, the Beast Hunters have not started. They're scheduled to start. Today's March 7th. They're supposed to start March 22nd or something like that. Anyway, I do like this, and I'm very happy I picked it up. Don't pay more than retail price for it. Make sure all the paint apps are okay on the grill, Autobot symbol and whatnot, before you pick one up. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please click the thumbs up icon at the bottom. Follow me on Twitter, Keek, Instagram, and check out my videos on Chefatron and FX Friends, as well as the videos I contribute to Tech Sushi. This has been the Transformers Prime Beast Hunters Deluxe Class Bumblebee. Thanks for watching.